Hey guys, what's up? Bisectatron here from OneHive Gazette, here with the next video, and today we're talking about Town Hall 9. It's been a long time since I've talked about Town Hall 9 on this channel. We don't have them anymore in OneHive Genesis, but I was in OneHive Origins for their finals of the EWL league they're in, and it kind of gave me some new life, some new appreciation for Town Hall 9. Not having seen it in a while. And guys, save yourself the trouble. I know you're right now, you're typing out the comment, Town Hall 9 is dead, something along those lines. And I wouldn't think of it in absolutes. You can say it's dead. It's definitely very unbalanced. It's very easy to three-star. But as we saw, if you guys saw my last video, the Dragon video, where I also showed some of the outcome of this finals that Origins was in, Town Hall 9 can make or break you, especially the lower league levels. So let's just go ahead and start this video. This is the one thing you guys can do as a Town Hall 9 to give yourself the best chance of defending. And what are you defending? Well, you're really defending witches. That is the main thing people are using at Town Hall 9. Not the only thing, but it's one of the bigger things you're seeing. My one tip, this can be a quick video because I don't have a whole lot to say, but my main tip is put your CC in the middle of your base and put Valkyries in it, at least two, if not more, because the Valkyries are a great counter to witches. Now, if the witches, or if the Valkyries lock on to your king, to the defensive, or to the offensive king, or a golem or something, they're not gonna do much damage, but sometimes, depending on how they're lured, they might target other things like the witches. Now, you can see right here, the poison actually doesn't quite kill them unless they're in it just the entire time, but they're quick, they're typically not gonna be in it the whole time. So in this case, those Valks run over and just destroy that entire side of the witches. Now, this attack is going to end up being a 3-star. We'll take a look at two attacks today. This one, despite that play by the Valkyries getting some good value, this one is going to triple. But you can see the attack is almost foiled there. And the Valkyries also take out the King's Barbarians. They pretty much render the King useless as well. So some very good value from those defensive Valkyries in the CC. And if you want to have a chance of defending at Town Hall 9, especially defending the popular witch strategies, you have to have the damage necessary to do so. People like using Lava Hounds, which I understand the appeal, but they don't do any damage really. The Lava Pups maybe, once it explodes, but it's really a type of thing that you don't want to use at Town Hall 9 because you need something to actually deal the damage, and the defenses aren't that strong at Town Hall 9, so having the maxed out Valkyries in the CC does quite a bit of damage and will just wreck any Town Hall 9 level witches they come across. Now, if we want to get a little more specific, a little more detailed here, you can have parts of your base where the CC is going to be lured unevenly. So as you can see here, the witches from this side, the base cuts in, there's a good chance that a witch that kind of starts walking up will lure out the CC before the actual golem push. So it's hard to do to predict that to some extent, and a good attacker isn't going to have their is going to have the CC lured by a golem or something out in front, not just naked witches on the outside that'll get destroyed by Valkyries. So that's something you have to keep in mind. But really, at Town Hall 9, you're not defending the good attacker who's attacking well. You're defending someone who's making a mistake, because it does take a little bit of luck at Town Hall 9. But as you can see, if you didn't see my last video, this is the tiebreaker of the EWL finals. Let me show the info for a second. EWL Ivory participants. That's the league. This is the finals, and this is the tiebreaker of the finals, which was tied. There was a Town Hall 9, Town Hall 10 split war where both clans had a perfect war. So now they go to 5 Town Hall 9s straight up, 5 attacks only. And this was the difference maker. So I will show this failed attack that made the difference by Ozzy here attacking. And I guess credit to this base for defending, because that's what won them the war. And you can see a golem actually lures the CC, but the poison's a little late, the damage of the queen as well, and the way the golem walks out of that poison spell is gonna allow those Valkyries to basically break free and go kill a bunch of witches, which is what makes this attack fail, basically. Town Hall 9 is so much room for error. I'm not saying that Town Hall 9 is a very competitive Town Hall level for defenders, but things like this can really break an attack. You can see the Valks can basically take out that entire side on their own, and this is how you're going to get it done. Now, there's other principles you have to have in your base just to have the opportunity to be able to defend, such as, you know, having difficult pathing into the base for bowlers, perhaps, having good placement on giant bombs, spring traps to kill hogs. There's other things you should be doing, but this is the one thing I think that is not being done enough, and it can be the difference maker if the attacker deals with the CC wrong. Now, in this case, the CC was offset, but I think a good attacker typically is going to just lure that CC and kill it with like a baby dragon or with the queen, knowing how valuable the CC really is for a defender at Town Hall 9. So with that all being said, I might put it in the middle of the base or maybe a little bit offset, because you don't want that typical lure where it goes in like a golem or something. You want it to lure awkwardly, and maybe putting it offset is the best way to do that, but it makes it easy also just to kill it off in the corner with some troops, like a baby dragon, poison, queen, whatever. So you got to keep that in mind as well. Maybe keep it somewhat offset. Anyway, that's all for me for this video. Hope it gave a little bit of insight for those of you Town Hall 9s out there, and for everyone else who's just watching this video to leave some comment about Town Hall 9 being dead. You know, you're not wrong to some extent in the grander scheme of things, but it still matters for wars like these, where Town Hall 9s have a much bigger role than they do in the wars we see at the higher levels. So that being said, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bisectatron out.